This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform photos that have aged over the course of time. I provided this PSD template consisting of two textures, scratches, and damaged film. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Keep in mind, you'll see only one texture after you click the link. However, when you download the file, you'll see both textures in the Layers panel. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click that like button, which lets YouTube know you like my stuff. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. We'll place the photo onto the textures file I provided. With your Move tool active, drag the photo onto the tab of the textures template. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize and reposition it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner. If you're using CC 2019 or later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it out or in. On earlier versions, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it. Then, drag it into position. To accept it, press Enter or Return. We'll crop off any parts of the photo that extend past the document's visible boundaries. To do this, press Ctrl or Command A to select the visible document, and go to Image and Crop. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Drag the photo to the bottom and temporarily hide both textures. Next, we'll add a frame along the inside border of our photo. Go to View. If you're using CC or later, click New Guide Layout. If you're using an earlier version, I'll show you a workaround in a minute. Make sure Snap is checked. If it isn't, click it to enable it, and then go back to New Guide Layout. If you can't see the guidelines, press Ctrl or Command H. Make sure Clear Existing Guides is checked. Make the number of columns and rows 1 each, and check Margin. Make each of them 0.24 inches. This adds guidelines approximately a quarter inch from each edge of our photo. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and feather it 0.5 pixels. Go to a corner of the guide and drag the selection diagonally across until it snaps to the opposite corner of the guide. Click the Layer Mask icon, which makes a layer mask of the selection, next to the photo. If you're using a version earlier than CC, just drag out a selection that approximates the frame and make a layer mask from that selection. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. We'll add a background color that will appear behind our photo as the frame. To do this, we'll make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl or Command clicking the New Layer icon. Click the foreground color to open the color picker. In the hexadecimal field, type in DBD1B7. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Our foreground color is now the color we just typed in. To fill the bottom layer with the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Make the old film texture visible and active. Change its blend mode to Multiply. Reduce its opacity to 40%. Press and hold Alt or Option as you drag the layer mask next to the old film texture. Pressing Alt or Option makes a copy of it. Make the scratches layer visible and active. Change its blend mode to Linear Burn and reduce its opacity to 50%. Go to the layer mask and again press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the scratches layer. We'll invert this layer mask by clicking it to make it active and pressing Ctrl or Command I. We'll make a copy of the layer and the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change its blend mode to Linear Dodge and invert the scratches layer. Make a layer mask active and invert it as well. Reduce this layer's opacity to 35%. To save some space in the Layers panel, let's place all of our textures into a folder. To do this, Shift-click the bottom texture layer to make all the layers active, and press Ctrl or Command G. Let's name it Textures. Make the photo active. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 3 pixels. Go back to Filter. If you're using version CC or later, click Camera Raw Filter. If you're using an earlier version, I'll show you a workaround in a minute. Open Effects and drag the vignetting to -45. If you don't have the Camera Raw Filter, go to Filter and Lens Correction. Open the Custom tab and drag the vignette all the way to the left. Next, we'll reveal back the sharpness in the center of the photo as it gradually blurs out along the edges. Make the layer mask active. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft round brush. Make its size 1200 pixels and its hardness 0%. Its opacity and flow are both 100%. Go to the center and click once. The blur filter softened the edge of the frame a bit too much, so we'll make it slightly sharper by opening the Textures folder and dragging a copy of the layer mask next to the photo. We can close the folder now. Make the photo active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Curves. We want this adjustment layer to affect just our photo and not the frame color under it. Since adjustment layers affect all the layers under them in the Layers panel, we'll need to clip it or restrict it to the one layer under it. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. In this panel, we can adjust the amount of red, green, and blue colors in your image by adjusting the red, green, and blue channels. Before we adjust them, keep in mind, since each photo has its own color characteristics, feel free to tweak the adjustments to tailor it to your photo. Click Red. Go to the center and drag the diagonal line to approximately here to increase the red colors of the midtones in your image. Open the green channel. Place your cursor approximately here and drag it down about this much to decrease the green colors in the darker areas of your image. Place your cursor approximately here and drag it up about this much to increase green in the lighter areas of your image. Open the blue channel and go to the center. Drag it down at an angle to about here to decrease the blue colors in the midtones. Again, whereas these adjustments work well for this photo, you may have to fine-tune them for yours. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. Clip it and reduce the color's vibrancy to -15 to replicate color fade that happens over time. Lastly, we're going to add light leaks that occur especially with old, inexpensive cameras. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Name it Light Leaks. Change its blend mode to Color Dodge and reduce its opacity to 50%. Click the foreground color and pick a bright red. Adjust the brush's size by making sure your caps lock key is off and pressing Ctrl or Command and the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Click on your photo at various points. If you're not happy with its location, just press Ctrl or Command Z to undo it. Another color that's often seen in light leaks is yellow. To ensure that the colors of the light leaks aren't throwing a color cast on the frame surrounding your photo, clip it to the photo. There's another way to clip it. Hover your cursor between the layer you want to clip and the layer below it, and press and hold Alt or Option. When you see this icon, click it. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.